multiplying polynomials. Is it blurry? There we go. Okay, so let's talk about multiplying polynomials. Before I go off into multiplying polynomials, let's remember something. So one of the rules we used to talk about back in chapter, this was like chapter 2. We had A times B plus C. How would I take care of that? Distributive property, right? So I would distribute the A. And I would get AB plus AC. Right. So we know the distributive property. Now that we're going to use that with polynomials. So say I have, for example, 4y times 8y squared plus 5. This 4y is my A. The 8y squared is my B. And the 5 is my C. So I'm going to do the same thing. I'm just going to distribute. So my first term is going to be my a, which is 4y, times my b, which is 8y squared, plus my a, which is 4y, times my c, which is 5. So we're talking about variables and polynomials, but it doesn't change anything. We're still just using the distributive property. What do I get out of this? 32. Y cubed. There's a 1 here. Yeah, there's always a 1 there. And then what do I get out of the second one?
20y.
20y. And then that's it. I can't combine these anymore because these are not like terms. So notice there's a difference when we're multiplying terms together as to when we're adding terms together. When we're adding terms together, I can't combine like terms. But when we are multiplying, I can. For example, here, I had y to the first power and y squared, and I added them together. So this right here, this step right here, is different than this step. Okay. So this is one way to do it. It's just using the distributive property that we already know of. Do you have a question?
Plus
sign
just puts a fish bar and break on it. You
can't go. Yeah, pretty much. Exactly. Mm-hmm. So this is one way to do it. Another way to do it, which might seem simple with this problem, but it'll come in handy later, is to make it into a table. So you can make a table, and then across the top of the table, you can write one of your polynomials. So I'm going to write the inside polynomial, which is 8y squared plus 5. And on the side of the table, I can write my other polynomial, which is 4y. Then what I'm going to do is fill in my missing pieces by just multiplying. So I'm going to fill in this piece by multiplying 4y times 8y squared. That's going to give me 32y cubed. And I'm going to fill in this piece by multiplying 4y plus 5. That gives me 20y. And anything that I filled in, that's my answer. That's my polynomial, which again is 32y cubed plus 20y. Same answer, just a different way of getting there. It might keep you a little more organized. Okay, let's try one. So let's say we have 3r times 8r squared minus r plus 11. I can do this using the distributive property. I would just distribute this 3r to everything inside. But let me do it using the table since I just went over that. So using the table, I'm going to have 3r on one side of the table, and the 8r squared, negative r, and positive 11 on the other side of the table. So it would look something like this. And then I'm just going to fill in the missing pieces by multiplying whatever the missing piece has. So to fill in this missing piece, I'm multiplying 3r times 8r squared. What does that get me? Mm-hmm. What about this piece, 3r times negative r? 2r?
Negative 3r.
To the 7.
Yeah, negative 3r to the second. Because there's a 1 power here. And on top of that, there's a 1 coefficient here. And then finally, 3r times 11. 33r. So my answer is simply 24r cubed minus 3r squared plus 33r. And that's it. Yeah, there are addition or subtraction of terms is what you're left with once you're here. So one of the things that you could do is you could always make sure you put a sign in there so you don't forget. Okay. And again, since this is addition of terms, if they're not like terms, I can't add them. I keep them like that. So far we've been multiplying. So what kind of polynomial is this one on the outside? Monomial. What kind of polynomial is on the inside?
Binomial.
What about here? What am I multiplying here?
A trinomial.
A monomial times a trinomial, right? So far we've been just multiplying monomials. That's easy. Let's talk about multiplying binomials times other polynomials. So multiplying binomials. So let's say we have b plus 3 times b plus 5. This is different than above, because above we just had one monomial that we would just distribute across the entire polynomial that was inside. Here we have a problem. We have a polynomial itself on the outside and a polynomial on the inside. So what we do is, we could do this using the distributive property, but it turns out to be a little bit complicated to explain. So the easiest way to do this is just to do it using your table. If you use your table, it's not different at all. I'm just going to write the first polynomial down one side, the second polynomial down the other side, and just fill in my missing pieces. Okay? So let's fill in b times b. What does that give me?
B squared.
B squared. B times 5 would give me 5b. 3 times b.
3 times 5.
So my answer would be b squared plus 5b plus 3b plus 15. And then I just have to note that I have a set of like terms here, 5b and 3b. So just combine those and I get b squared plus 8b plus 15. That's my final answer. Okay. You probably heard of a different way to do this, which is using FOIL. So using FOIL. Yeah. FOIL is a method for multiplying binomials, and it's the same thing we just did. So FOIL says multiply your first terms together, that's the F in FOIL. Multiply your outer terms together, that's the O in FOIL. Multiply your inner terms together, that's the I in FOIL. And then multiply your last terms together. So FOIL, first, outer, inner, last. You multiply your first terms, your outer terms, your inner terms, and your last terms. So in FOIL, you're essentially doing the same thing we did here, which is multiply our first two terms, our outer terms, our inner terms, and our last terms. So if you use the table, you don't need to remember FOIL. And FOIL can only be used with two binomials. Okay, let's try another one. So let's say I have 7x minus 1, let's hope it focuses, times 5x plus 4. So I can do this using FOIL, which means I would multiply the first terms, the outer terms, the inner terms, and the last terms, or I can just use my table. So I'm just going to use my table. So 7x minus 1 down one side of the table, 5x plus 4 down the other side of the table. Just fill in the missing pieces. So what do I get from multiplying 7x times 5x? Square. 7x times 4. Negative 1 times 5x. And finally, negative 1 times 4. So then what I just filled in, that's my answer. So my answer. Yeah, I have to combine these two because they're like terms. So this one and this one are like terms, and when I combine them, I get plus 23x. Good. Let's talk about squaring binomials. Six y minus one squared. So here I have a binomial that I'm squaring. I want to point out to you that this is not the same thing as the third rule. Remember the third rule said x times y to the a power? And then it said that I can give x to the a, y to the a, something like this. This is not the same thing as that rule that we talked about in the previous section. Because x and y are being multiplied here, and here they're being added or subtracted. So it's not the same thing. So you can't use this rule, basically, is what I'm trying to get at. Instead, what we have to do is we have to talk about what we know about expanding. What we know about expanding is that 6y minus 1 squared, if I wanted to expand that, that's the same thing about... That's the same thing as 6y minus 1 times 6y minus 1. That's what squared means, times itself. And then this I know how to do, because I just learned how to do something like this. How do I do this? Foil or use my table, right? So if I do this, let's go ahead and do our table. 6y minus 1 times 6y minus 1. I get 36y squared minus 6y minus 6y plus 1. Let me go ahead and write out my polynomial. What do I get when I combine the two middle terms? Negative 12y. So a lot of people think that they cancel out. Make sure you don't think that. They don't, because they're both negative. So you just add up the numbers, keep the negative sign. If one were negative and one were positive, then they would cancel out. Otherwise, they don't. Let's say I have 3x plus 2 squared. How would I do this? Expand it, and then and then foil or put it on the table. Can you guys tell me what you get out of this? 9x squared plus 4. Yeah, that's right. Any questions about that? How we get there? Okay. So, in short, when you see something like this squared, do not just make it 3x squared times 2 squared, which would give you 9x squared plus 4. So notice these are not the same thing, so don't just make it. And the reason I make a big point of it is I guarantee you somebody will do it. It always happens.
Well, where does that rule, why do we need to know that rule for this? Because it's not really going to be related.
It is when we have something like we did before.
With it a monomial, then it would apply, but if it's a binomial, it doesn't.
Right, but sometimes, so for example, you may have an unsimplified problem where you have a monomial to some power times a binomial or trinomial or something.
So, those rules that you taught us, doesn't that only apply for multiplication?
Yes. So, but if you notice, what we're doing here is we are multiplying terms times one another. So we need to know the rules we learned to multiply these terms to fill in the samples and the rules.
Okay. For the rules itself?
The rules itself only apply to monomials, but to multiply polynomials, we need to multiply monomials together. Got terms
that's,
together.
That's what I'm trying.
Do you have a question?
Oh, no, I just
saw that. Okay, good. So let's try one more where we have something like 2x plus 5 times x squared plus 4x minus 1. So this is an example in which we cannot use FOIL straight up because we don't have two binomials that we're multiplying. FOIL means first, outer, inner, last, but we might have more than a couple of inner terms and more than a couple of all the inner terms. We have more than one. So we can't use FOIL, but we can use our table. And using our table, it's not any different at all. We use our table, we get 2x plus 5 on one side, and x squared plus 4x minus 1. The only thing it is just more rows and more columns.
Isn't it just an extended FOIL? Like, you take the first thing and go all the way across?
You can think of it as an extended FOIL. Yep. So then we get, out of these two, we get 2x cubed. Out of these two, we get... Negative 2x. 5x squared. And finally the last one. Negative 5. Then I'm going to figure out my like terms are and combine them. So my like terms are, I have a couple of x squared like terms. So that's going to give me 2x cubed, 8x squared, and 5x squared. It's going to give me 13x squared, and 20x, and negative 2x. And it gave me 18x minus 5. That's it.